Hi, I'm Stu.
And welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at all the new features that have dropped in the latest update of LumaFusion 3.1 by LumaTouch. Let's get started. The standout update in this latest release has got to be working with video scopes. But we're not here to talk about that just quite yet. I want to talk about LUTs, because now we can add multiple LUTs to a video clip. When you want to add a LUT, highlight a video clip, tap on your little pencil icon, go to color and effects, and then from there you want to choose a LUT. Now there's two different ways of applying a LUT. There's a LUT that you would apply to do your sort of baseline grade if you were working in like flat or log mode in the likes of Filmic Pro. You have then the option to apply other LUT for color grading. For this one, tap on LUTs and then I'm going to go right to the very end and use D flat. You can see before and after. And what I'm going to do is just blend and reduce things by around about 0.35 just to take the edge off that particular LUT. Now previously what you would have had to have done was applied your baseline LUT that does the initial color grade and then save it out and bring it back in and then apply a more creative LUT for color effect. But now with 3.1 we can just quite easily choose another LUT. For example, we can add color pop as before, as after, and again we'll just reduce the effect a little bit, take it down to 0.40. And if you wish, you can change the order of these as well. And the great thing is you can add as many LUTs as you want now. I don't know what the upper limit is, but generally speaking, you're not going to want to add any more than a couple of LUTs per video clip anyway, unless you were doing something really out there and sort of wacky color wise. So once you've got these set up, then all you really need to do is save these out as a preset, a temporary preset. So we'll just call these running color and that'll do. And that means when you go back out to the rest of the clips, you can either do them individually and just tap on them and tap on your running color. And that then applies the two LUTs to the video clip with the adjustment actually made. See if you're doing copy and paste. And obviously another way you could work it is to do multiple clip selections and then apply the running color that way. It's then been applied to all the video clips. Switch off multi-selection and that's us done our basic grading. Now if I wanted to, I could go into one particular clip. For example, we have a match cut here which we can work towards. So in the second part, we can highlight this one, double tap it or tap your pencil, whatever one you want to work to. And you'll see I've already got this prepared so that I can choose our LUTs and then go to a particular color effect, action green for example. Come back out and then we can go from one color to the next color. And there we go. That's one of the many new features that LumaTouch has brought to us in LumaFusion 3.1. In the next video tutorial, we're going to, of course, take a look at the video scopes. I'll catch you on that one. See you later.
If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up, as it really helps the channel. Don't forget to subscribe for more video tutorials every week, and ring the bell to get notified of when Stu has uploaded a new video tutorial. You have been watching. I am Stu. See you later.